In this present crisis, government is not the solution to our problem. Government is the problem.
This is a day of affirmation, a celebration of liberty. We stand here in the name of freedom. At the heart of that Western freedom and democracy is the belief that the individual man, the child of God, is the touchstone of value, and all society, all groups and states exist for that person's benefit. Therefore, the enlargement of liberty for individual human beings must be the supreme goal and the abiding practice of any Western society. The first element of this individual liberty is the freedom of speech, the right to express and communicate ideas, to set oneself apart from the dumb beasts of field and forest, the right to recall governments to their duties and to their obligations.
Oh, I wish I was in the land of cotton. Old times there are not forgotten. Look away, look away, look away, Dixieland. Wish I was in Dixie, away, away in Dixieland. I would take my stand to live and die in Dixie, Dixieland. That's where I was born. On one frosty morning, look away, look away, look away, Dixieland.
Glory. So who is my neighbor? That's a fair question today, as we become increasingly shut in from real human contact and more profoundly attached to our gadgets and our social networks and our security measures, forgetting about the very people that put their lives on the line every day for us. And as Jesus sent out the 72 appointed laborers in pairs of two, you know why he sent them in twos? So that they could strengthen each other. So that they could help each other, so that they wouldn't forget each other. One could strengthen, one could lift. Doesn't that make sense? And he tells them, I send you out as lambs among wolves. Well, we're still going out as lambs across the many areas of this world, trying to make a difference. And Jesus tells them, like he told us, take nothing with you, but go in my power. So many young men and women today getting sent out into the world, whether it be in the military or otherwise, ill-equipped, in their own power, backed by a government that can't even seem to get together on a budget. Holding back death benefits from families that right now might not think about that money, because how do you get enough money to bring back somebody you love? None of this is surprising, God, for he said it would be like that. And people always ask the same questions over and over and over again. They ask the same question. Who is my neighbor?
God bless you.
Who is my neighbor?
Who are
who is my neighbor? And Jesus tells us in that famous parable about the man coming down that road from Jerusalem to Jericho and becoming accosted and beaten and slain and laid by the road. And one priest passed by, and then a Levite passed by, much like we pass by. And they keep passing by, leaving people broken and wounded on the sides of the road. Conventional Christianity can no longer do it in their own power. Like that biker gang that harassed and chased and ultimately caught and beat that man while his family watched. You think people were quick to help? And we keep walking by and passing by, but there was a Samaritan. And even though he and that man had nothing in common, like most Americans, he stopped and he bound them up. And he even mixed oil and wine together and put them on his beast. And he took him in to the inn. And he paid the price for that day and the next day. And even said, if there's anything else, when I come, you can charge me then. Well, that's a picture of our Jesus. Our Jesus was like that Samaritan. And he came and he found you. And he found me. Because we're both the priests that pass by and do nothing. And we're also the one that gets jumped and robbed and left dying. Satan has jumped and robbed us and wounded us with sin in our lives. He attacks all day, every day. And he's not trying to recruit you, friend. He's trying to kill you. And that Samaritan, again, is a perfect illustration of our Lord, who finds us a sinful and sin-filled, miserable human beings and dead. Not half dead, like the man on the road, but fully dead in trespasses. But he doesn't forsake us. Instead, he has compassion on us, comes to earth as a man and suffers on that cross for our sins, paying that price then and forever. Then was resurrected and going to his Father, left us not enough money for the next day, but left us the Holy Spirit because the price was paid in full to guide us. So that with the understanding that he gave his life for us, that we would never turn our backs on friend or foe. That we, having been transformed by the renewing of our minds, would do all we could, using all that he gives us freely to help our neighbor in need and distress. And those within the sound of my voice that are still bleeding by the side of the road, dead in your sin, we as your neighbors are here to introduce you to the only physician that can heal you. To love God first and to love your neighbor as thyself. You are that neighbor. And so is everyone else in the world. God bless you. God bless all those young women in the United States military.